When Thomas Edison invented the electric light bulb, it wasn't the least expensive technology of its day. The kerosene lamp was the economical solution, but the light bulb was the better technology. And to mankind's credit, we developed it, despite the cost of its implementation. Our time now in history is similar. We are on the brink of an age where the fuel cell will become the silicon chip of the future, the hydrogen age. The quality of future life on planet Earth depends upon the widespread use of environmentally clean energy. Today, mankind has the opportunity to begin a logical transition toward clean energy. That time to begin is now. This is Spaceship Columbia. On board, stored hydrogen fuels its life support systems in space. The byproduct of this conversion is pure water. Solar panels and hydrogen fuel cells create electricity to power its systems. It is propelled by hydrogen fuel. Here in the vacuum of space, man has devised ways to successfully sustain life, to generate the power to work and transport himself, all with fuels that leave no harmful byproduct. This is Spaceship Earth. Here, nature has provided the ingredients to sustain life. But in man's quest to power progress, he chose energy sources that were convenient for their times. Today, the pollution they are creating is quickly undoing what took nature millions of years to create. The widespread use of fossil fuels are destroying Earth's fragile atmosphere and waters. If man can develop technology that can sustain life and power machinery in space, all with no wasteful byproducts, then why can't he develop this technology to save his home planet? Happily, the answer is that he can. Today, mankind has the opportunity to bring the energy technologies of space travel down to Earth. The simplest and most abundant element in the universe is hydrogen. Hydrogen is the fuel of choice for a pollution-free future. Production of hydrogen creates none of the disposal problems of nuclear power. Hydrogen is energy that can be easily stored and saved, while electricity cannot. The hydrogen fuel cells that today power the life support systems in space can be developed to fuel the life support systems of future cities on Earth, creating water as a byproduct. The hydrogen that transports spaceships today can one day be used to transport trains, buses, and automobiles with clean steam as its byproduct. All that is needed is the leadership and commitment to begin the transition to the new hydrogen age. The costs of new technologies will be high, and the results may take decades. The timing of this future success depends upon the actions of government and business leaders today. In a hydrogen economy, no wars will be fought over finite resources. We will never run out of hydrogen. It is abundant everywhere for those with the technology to use it. In a hydrogen economy, oceans and skies will return to the way nature intended. Who will be the first to take the steps needed to build a hydrogen economy? Who will lead the way into the hydrogen age of the future?
Up she goes. Up, 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 up. Hang on. Up. Okay, now.
The Jetstar mounts just behind the cab, between the frame. It's bolted on. The hydrogen and oxygen are run up under the frame, up here to the front engine. And the hydrogen and oxygen is fed into the engine just after the turbocharger on the other side. Just fed in there at that 90-degree fitting over there.
Looks like quite the unit, and I'm hearing a lot of good things about it, but I'll let you know.
Excellent.
I wasn't really into it at first, but now I'm getting into it.
So what do you think of the second install here? You're getting someone joining you.
Yeah, it'd be nice. It'd be nice to see about 20 more on the road.
So what do you think of this thing? What's going on here?
I'm watching the RPMs right now, and they're not jumping. They're staying steady. And there's lots of power. They're just...
So are we making you a believer, Wally?
Yeah, you are.
What's our speed, Wally?
Right now we're doing 60, 70 kilometers. And we're in ninth gear. Just better 1,400 RPMs. Less than that.
Is that good or bad?
That's good. Right now I'm doing 12 and I'm running 60 kilometers. And that's in ninth gear. That's really well.
He took off in 12.
What do you think?
He was in high 12.
Yeah.
We were almost... He said, "Do you see what happened? It's in 12. That, well, we just went down to a lower gear."
I'm Dan McTague, Member of Parliament for Pickering, Ajax, and Uxbridge, and the Vice Chair of the House of Commons Industry Committee. I am fascinated with what I've seen over the past 3.5 hours. I've learned much about dynamic fuel systems. As many know, our government committed our country to reducing emissions and to improving the use of fossil fuels in terms of more cleaner environment. To that end, what Dynamic Fuels has proposed here meets and exceeds the federal government's commitment, which was a very lofty commitment, a very controversial one. If we can somehow ensure that people using and burning fossil fuels limit the amount and at the same time increase efficiency, then we've not only met the goals of Kyoto, we may have been able to point the way for the rest of the world. And I'm not often willing to say something like that, but from what I've seen here, it's extremely exciting. I'm encouraged sufficient to talk directly with the Minister of the Environment, the Honourable David Anderson, and hopefully the Honourable Herb Dellewall, Minister of Natural Resources, even though there are other implications, including reduction in terms of the nasty side of things as it relates to health. Less consumption means, of course, and less fuels being burnt, of course, means a cleaner environment. But more importantly, it does something to the bottom line for business, which is good for the nation. And from that perspective, it has a very strong industrial potential. I'm excited. If I weren't involved with conflict of interest guidelines, I'd want to own the company, as Victor Kayam said. But suffice it to say, I think this is a very important day for me, and it's a very important day for the environment and certainly for our economy.
It's improved my fuel economy. Right now I'm up to about 25%. It's come up slowly week by week. There's next to no exhaust coming out my truck. I don't even think I can see any when I'm going down the road. A dramatic improvement in power in the truck. It's just amazing. No more lugging on hills. It really, really, really works well.
I'm just walking around Eric's truck, and he just got his refuel of jet fuel.
And here's a full bottle. Let's remove the cap.
This guy's old hat at this now.
Oh yeah, this is easy. Just put it on, put it down, and turn it in. Oh, sorry. Oh,
that's
good idea.
Okay.
Get out of your way there, and just twist it back in. That's all there is to it. Come when they put it on, when they hit the TSC and actually list on the TSC that day, I'm buying regardless. She goes, "Well, you know, we're just on the fight of how much now, because I did promise, and I hate breaking, especially my kids. I don't like breaking promises, and I did promise them I put the pool in. So if I put the money in this, I'm breaking the promise to the kids, which that's where I have a problem. And that I'm trying to work my way around that one right now.
It's exciting to see here in this community a new business starting up, where people have a vision that not only for a new business, but a vision for a new product that could well solve many of the energy problems that we're seeing here in Canada these days, making sure there's an energy supply for families, for our communities.
This is what America thinks from the drivers that have seen the unit when I've been on the road. At first they think it's some kind of heater I got on the truck. Then I explain to them what it is. When I open up the unit and I show them the bottle, they shake their heads again, and they just rattle and hum. And I tell them, you know, you guys want to keep forking it out to all these big oil giants that you guys keep complaining about all the time. I said, well, this is one way to get back to them. And then the light clicks in their head and they go, yeah. So, yes, it's catching a lot of them by surprise, but I mean, they're in the same boat I'm in.
What I see with Jetstar here is something that demonstrates in a safe way and in a way that can be scientifically demonstrated and proven as to how inevitably, eventually, we will be a complete hydrogen society. We're not even close to that right now. But people are going to look back at this some 20 years from now and go, aha, that was the time that we made the first step. And because we made that first step, all of the other steps were possible.
The more it's on your truck, the better it's going to be. It's working more. It's just like everything else. The more it works, the better it's going to run. It's starting to clean my exhaust that I've noticed in, let's say, 500 miles. I already noticed the difference of my pipes. It's not so black anymore. It's cleaning up pretty good. So I'm actually expecting more.
In a month, I'm saving about $700, $800 a month.
And that equates to how many miles do you think you're driving?
I do about 2,500 miles a week on the East Coast.
Wow.
I'm saving about, like a trip, a round trip, I'm saving about 150 liters a round trip.
Yeah, wow.
Oh, wow.
Looks good. Dynamic fuel systems.
Yeah. Oop. Look back.
Yeah, let's have a look-see. That's beautiful.
Yeah, it is nice.
What do you think of it?
That is nice.
I've got here Frank Dallison as an advisor to our company, Dynamic Fuel Systems. We've got Dave Youngs, our fleet manager. We've got Wally Palmer, who's the driver of the CCC truck. And the brainchild is Tom Fairful. What do you think, guys?
All in here. Right. And our Vancouver distributor.
We've got Paul Behrens. We have a gentleman that flew out from Vancouver. He's a distributor for the West Coast. His name's Paul Behrens, president of the Synergy Distribution.
Okay, here we are in the corner of the new building. Are you guys excited about this thing? But I'm gonna love you.
Something in my own place. I'm studio naked, smiling. I feel no disgrace with who I am. I'm going. I watch you look up and watch my feet are growing. I know just who I am. And how many corners do I have to turn? How many times do I have to run?
We're making good progress as far as patents and things go.
Good.
Very, very good. We're making real good progress.
If you get the same amount of power, you'll actually have one. That'll be a $75,000 Jetstar US. And then we'll take that one and we'll put it on those 6,000 generators with one Taurus. So that's a deal pending.
Okay. All right.
Happiness coming and going. I watch you live up and watch my fever grow, and I know just where I am. How many times do I have to learn?
you get in the truck and I just turn it on and off when I pull it out and say, holy God, I can't believe this. It's like a turbo. It's just like a nitro oxide.
Yeah.
Nitro.
With fire.
Good turnout of the shareholders, lovely reception, very nice building, very keen, very excited about the product. It's going to be one of the products that's going to be revolutionary and for the automotive, especially the trucking industry to start with.
How many corners do I have to turn? How many times do I have to run? All the love I have is in my mind. I hope you understand.
Powerful. Fuel economy is terrific. Just an amazing concept. Yeah. And we're sold.
Excellent, excellent. We're really impressed. I think it's a great transition product for hydrogen, which is going to be a long time in the future. The fuel cell vehicles, this is going somewhere.
But it sounds great. I mean, it's just not too noisy. It's
a whole new perspective. Yeah. Like riding on top of a mountain, actually.
The Jetstar only draws between 12 and 14 amps. So there's very little draw on a generator. It's producing all the time. The thing's spinning all the time. Very interesting. A lot more power. It's spinning all this time.
And you can feel it.
This company is on its way up, no question about it. We'll be reading about this for years.
And finally, do you have anything?